my husband and I are business owners, and I think that when Tim was a young age, probably I'm thinking around age 13 or 14, he said to his dad, "I want to be a business owner someday." And that idea kept forming. And then when he was a senior in high school, he was hired by a restaurant, a local restaurant, Red Robin, a chain, and to be a host. And when that happened, and we saw just what a natural he was, greeting customers, seating them, talking to, he was uplifting to the customers, he was uplifting to the employees. One of our favorite stories was, you know, as a parent, you go in, we of course became regulars at this restaurant, and you go in and you're waiting for, okay, what do we need to fix here? Or what's he doing that's a problem? You know, just a parental thing. And one day we go in and there was a bartender there. I'll never forget him. He's like, "Oh, Mr. and Mrs. Harris, I really need to talk to you." And we're like, "Oh no." And then the manager came by and goes, "Oh, don't go before I have a chance to talk to you." We thought, "Oh no, this is a problem." Because we had offered even, you know, he was still in high school. We had available to him job coaches and things like that. And at Red Robin, when they hired him, they said, "We offered that." And they said, "Oh no, we have our own training program and we'll train him ourselves." So, okay. So we go in expecting, okay. You know, Greta, one thing I want to share with people about this story is, and we've experienced this in Tim's restaurant and in other places that he's worked, it's like people are afraid to tell Tim no. They're afraid they're going to hurt his feelings. They're afraid, you know, they just don't want to be the one to upset him or make him sad or make him mad. And unfortunately, he gets away with that. And so we're afraid, like, we were afraid that he was pushing the limits and nobody was afraid, that nobody had knew what to do to set limits. And so we wanted to be there just to make sure. So that was our background going in that day. And we walked in and the bartender comes over to us and he said, "I have to tell you something." He said, "I can't have a bad day when your son's working here." And we're like, we're ready for a bad thing. We're like, "This is bad." You know, like, and he's like, "No," he said, "I wake up at the wrong side of the bed some mornings. I've got two kids. I'll wake up, you know, in a bad mood and yell at them and yell at my wife. And then I come and walk in this restaurant and there's Tim standing there ready to say hi to me or give me a hug." And he goes, "I can't hang on to it. I cannot have a bad day when I'm with your son." And that was amazing. And so then when the restaurant manager comes by, he comes with a big stack of paperwork and he showed us, long story short, our sales are up on the days that your son works here. And that's when we knew that Tim owning a restaurant was the right path to go on. And that's what led to us helping Tim start his dream of a restaurant.
Potion.